All right, let's get to our final off-the-record parting shots. Mike Miller, we'll start with you.
Well, I would just say what we've talked about a little bit today with all the Democrats in the primary and so forth for president starting in next month in January or so, and I suppose through the first week or two in November, whenever the election is, we are going to become inundated with more political ads than we've ever had, which 4 years ago I thought was impossible.
Every year it gets more.
Yes.
Joe.
Mike, I think the eventual elimination of the death penalty is absolutely inevitable as time goes by. We've seen in the past 40 years a gradual increase in the legal restrictions from the demands that juries review these things and so on. And you mentioned something that reminded me, our own county prosecutor, Ron O'Brien, in that death penalty case, the recent one, said, if we were doing this 15 years from now, we wouldn't be talking about the death penalty.
All right, Jerry.
I say that sometime next year, John Kasich will be spotted at a music festival, maybe Coachella, maybe Bonnaroo, but he'll be seen somewhere out now that he's an empty nester.
Well, he went to the heavy metal one at the Crew Stadium while he was governor.
Yeah, so.
Laura.
I think that 2020 is going to be a wild year to cover politics, and I am firmly of the belief that Ohio will be a swing state that should not be taken for granted or written off by either party.
All right. I think as history looks back on the past week, the vote that might tell who wins the next presidential election may not be the impeachment vote, but the vote to approve the new NAFTA, the U.S.-Mexico-Canada trade agreement, which will have economic impacts and may help the economy and thus help President Trump in the fall.